see a Thayer Schooner. With a mainmast soaring to 105 feet, the C.A. Thayer is a sight to behold. Typical of the three-masted schooners that sailed the West Coast, she had a cargo capacity of over 500,000 board feet. It must have been an amazing sight to see the Thayer when her decks were stacked with freshly milled Douglas fir boards and her sails were billowing. Many are looking forward to seeing the masts tower once more over Hyde Street Pier when restoration at the Alameda Shipyards is completed in 2006. The C.A. Thayer was built in 1895 by Danish shipwright Hans D. Bendixson and named for Clarence A. Thayer, who was part of the E.K. Wood Lumber Company. With a crew of only 8 men, the C.A. Thayer often carried lumber south to Mexico and even ventured as far as the Fiji Islands. Her lumber shipping days lasted from 1895 until 1912, at which time she sustained heavy damage from a southeasterly gale. At this time, the Thayer began her new career. Every April, for 12 years, she hauled salt and barrel staves from San Francisco to Alaska. Summers were spent anchored off western Alaska, where the fishermen cast their nets for salmon. Each autumn, workers loaded the Thayer for her heavily laden trip back to San Francisco, with the barrels now full of salted salmon. Normally, the Thayer waited out the winters in San Francisco Bay. But at the outbreak of World War I, when freight charges experienced a large increase, the Thayer also served as a cargo ship transporting lumber to Australia and bringing back coal or dried coconut meat, known as copra. From the mid to late 1920s, the Thayer reinvented herself again as a fishing ship, making cod runs to the Bering Sea. During World War II, her masts were removed, and she served her duty as an ammunition barge in Alaskan waters. After the war, her masts were restored, and the cod fishing resumed. On a good day, over 300 cod could be caught within a 5-hour period. The Thayer had over 50 years of service and 3 distinct careers. In 1950, the Thayer finally retired and went down in history as the last commercial sailing vessel on the West Coast. She was designated a National Historic Landmark in 1984.